Welcome to another video from Dialed In DIY. Today we're taking a look at how to make your own single serving containers that are perfect for travel, camping, or just taking with you on the go. Simple to make, all you need are some straws, a lighter, and a pair of pliers of some sort, and you're ready to go. This is a perfect little hack that my father taught me when I was younger. You can take a straw, cut it in half, pinch it with a pair of pliers, use a lighter to melt up the end of it a little bit. Then I let it cool, wipe my finger across the top just to make sure it's sealed, and that's all there is to it. Seal up the rest of your straws and you're ready to move on with the project. Start with a clean workspace so that you know you're not going to catch anything on fire that you don't intend to. And I'll actually run this first one through in real time so that you can see it from beginning to end. I'm using a general multipurpose oil to make myself a little tool that I can carry with me to work on some projects with. Got to be careful when you're using oil because when I light this one up, it does catch on fire. I should have wiped it off a little bit beforehand, but that's a good quick lesson to learn too. Just be careful not to burn yourself here. A little tube of oil like this can come in quite handy. Actually, in a lot of projects, there's tight spots it's hard to get into. If you take the tube, tip it to an end, find a corner, take a little needle and poke a hole in it, you can actually get very precise into where you want to put a drop or two of oil. You can always then seal it back up and save it for another time if you want to. For most fluids, I actually find it's easiest just to take some kind of a syringe. You can get them from your pharmacy, used for cough medicines and children's medicines, and just slowly drip it into the straw. The bigger the straw, the easier it is to fill. This also works great for anything you want to keep dry like matches, for throwing them in a backpack to take on a hike. Just make sure when you seal it with the end that's away from the match head. When using a syringe with fluids, just make sure to leave enough space between the syringe itself and the straw to allow the air to escape. A different fill technique is needed for thicker fluids, so I squeeze the straw a little bit to get rid of the air and then start to fill the fluid into it. As I do so, I like to release the straw and allow it to then fill back up. It's kind of like an injection process. I use a different approach with dry goods. I make a funnel out of a piece of post-it note. Start by just wrapping it around my finger and then using the adhesive on the note itself to seal it together. This works perfect for stuff like salt, but no matter how many times I've done this, I can't seem to do it without spilling a bunch of it all over the place anyway, so hopefully you have a little bit better luck keeping it clean. I use yet another approach with the finer powders. Basically, you just push the straw in and allow pressure to fill it. I've even used this for throat sprays, but to be honest, I really am not going to vouch for anything that you're going to consume in terms of a long-term viability, so make what you need and use it, and then make more when you need it again. Like other consumables, this is something I make for when it's needed. I wouldn't keep it and store it this way, but it's great for a quick pack trip. Gotta have the hot sauce, and this is another great one where squeezing the air out of the straw first really helps in filling. I use the vitamin E oil actually just to show you another technique for filling, and it's pretty much a tap and drip approach, and it really is great for thicker fluids. If you sealed the first side well, when you turn a fluid-filled tube upside down, everything will stay right inside until you're ready to use it. Coming soon to Dialed In DIY, I'll show you how I dialed it in just a little bit further and took the same approach and made some reusable glow sticks that you can make too. Thank you for watching. Please press like and then subscribe. There will be more Dialed In DIY to come.